Success over an 82-game grind gives a team the right to take the next step, to dance in the Stanley Cup playoffs. But for the Pittsburgh Penguins, the quest to reach the top of the NHL's mountain begins here in Uniondale, New York, as they collide with the New York Islanders in round one, game one at Nassau Coliseum. Comes back to Rust, who chips it out to center ice. Penguins moving right to left in this first period. Back in come the Isles. Kunackle, a shot, he scores! The former Penguin with the first goal of this series, and it's 1-0 New York just 33 seconds in.
Hold the phone. This is very close to being offside. Cal Clutterbuck had just come to the bench, and Kunackle came onto the ice, and the puck rolled right to him, and he came right down the middle of the ice. This is very close to being offside. Kunackle used Chris Letang as a screen, and he goes over the left glove hand of Matt Murray. But hold the phone here.
Mike Sullivan conferring with Mark Recchi on the Penguins bench, and it does appear there's going to be a review here. Let's go down to ice level. Francois St. Laurent, the official.
You're challenging the play for offside. After review, the play was deemed to be offside, therefore rolling on the ice is overturned. We have no goal. Please reset the clock to 1929.
And now lead steering it down low for Barzell. To the far point, it comes Adam Pelika, shot loose atop the crease. Everly turns, fires, and scores. So the Isles do get the first goal, this time off the stick of Jordan Everly. And a minute 40 in, it's 1-0 New York.
Oh boy, Brian Dumoulin is beside himself. This is a unforced turnover on Brian Dumoulin. And that to me is rust right there. Rust on the game of Brian Dumoulin. He never, ever turns a puck over like this. But he went behind his own cage and he just panicked. And he threw it up the middle of the ice. There was nobody there. He put it right onto the stick of Adam Pelech, who threw it towards the cage. It bounces off of Jordan Eberle. And Matt Murray, moving from his right to left, opened up the wickets. And Eberle put a five-hole, and now it is 1-0 Islanders.
Boy, great to see him back. Pedersen, nice play. He comes to the circle right in front. Great stop by Leonard on Hornquist. Back across it goes.
As he backtracks in his own end, now skates over the Islander logo at center ice. Simone over the attacking line to the slot. Leaves it for Kessel between the circle. Snapshot, score! Bill Kessel answers for the Penguins, and they're even 1-1.
Oh, feel the thrill. That wicked wrister. As Dominic Simone is able to enter the zone. And next thing you know, it is on the stick of Phil Kessel. Right-hand shot. He takes a little stutter step to the right as he's coming right down the middle of the slot. And he rips it five-hole on Robin Leonard. Oh, baby, we're tied at one.
Well, the calendar is flipped to the postseason. Here's Phil Kessel. He has arrived.
Yeah, that wasn't actually a pass by Dominic Simone. He had the puck poke checked off his stick by Scott Mayfield. It came right to Phil Kessel, and he rips it five-hole on Leonard.
Nelson, who finds Bailey. Back into the slot, he plays it for Taves in the Pittsburgh zone to the far circle, Everly. Back in front, Lee, a chance, he scores! Brock Nelson, atop the Penguins' crease, buries it. A power play goal for the Islanders, and it's 2-1 New York.
Well, I didn't like the decision by Brian Rust on a 2-on-1 to try a backhand saucer pass to Matt Cullen. The quick counterattack by the Islanders. And before the Penguins can get their penalty kill reset, they get it down low. And the Penguins don't take Nelson in front. It's Eberle who was figured in on both goals. He makes a little dipsy-doodle move around Chris Letang. And before Brian Dumoulin can get back to the front of the net, Nelson's all by himself. And he chips it over the left pad to Matt Murray to give the Islanders a lead back. It's now 2-1. Too easy.
On the forehand, snaps cross ice for Barzell at the far circle. Matt Barzell Looking back to the point, broken up by Gensel. Kessel's out of the box. He takes a feed from Gensel. Ahead of the pack, down the right wing, shoots it. Save made by the right pad of Leonard. Passes back to the point for Schultz. Walking the blue line in the near circle for Malkin. Malkin thinks shot, now shoots, score! A change of direction on the way through, but it's going to go to Evgeny Malkin. Power play goal for Pittsburgh. 2-2.
Shoot the puck, Gino. I wanted to scream it through the headset. On the first pass, it was for a one-timer. And there was a hesitation. And then Gino finally just wrists it at the cage. And I believe it hits the stick of Adam Pellick. It jumps up over the blocker of Robin Leonard. And we are tied at two.
Lundqvist. His pass deflects off the stick of Kunako out to center. It comes to McCann in on the attack. Down the right wing on the backhand. Centering in front. Malkin shoots. Save made. The rebound stopped as well. It's loose atop the crease. Leonard, not one but two strong saves on Evgeny Malkin in tight. Bodies come together there. Matta and Clutterbuck. As it bounces to the far wall, Adam Pellick, the defenseman up on the play, shoots it side of the net for Clutterbuck. Murray slides across, makes the save, and covers up.
Matthew Murray. Another big save by Matt Murray. As the Penguins wingers, in my estimation, have had a tough time with the Islanders' defense pinching down the wall of being more disruptive. And this is just a bang-bang play. Now, Brian Rust isn't ready for the puck to come along the wall. It's kept in by the left D, and he quickly gets it to Clutterbuck, who tries to one-time it and beat Matt Murray to the glove side. And Matt Murray pushes off and out to Rob Clutterbuck.
Islanders looking to capitalize. Down the right wing, it's Scopola in the near circle. Throws one towards the net, save made by Murray. The rebound. Komarov tracks it down. Back in front, it comes to the high slot. Letty a drive. Deflection, they score. It hit a body on the way through and bounced past Murray. And the Islanders capitalize on the momentum. They take the lead back, 3-2.
I'm going to go back to the icing on this one. The Penguins just should not. They iced the puck back-to-back times. They never got in the offensive zone again. You mentioned some tired bodies out there off of the Matta icing. So they're barely able to get it out of the zone. They go for a line change. The Isles counterattack right back. And the Penguins never get set in a defensive posture. And a knuckle puck by Nick Letty, a puck with eyes, with lots of traffic in front, goes off the post and in, and the Islanders lead 3-2.
7:25 to play. In regulation, the Islanders with the lead. Play back underway as the Islanders win the draw. It's Pellick flipping it into the Penguin zone. So the Pens for the third time in this game playing from behind. Centering pass in front. Matt Martin denied point blank by Murray. Huge stop there as it's loose atop the crease and the Penguins survive and flip it out to center. Far circle he finds Malkin. Back for Letang. Left circle Schultz a shot. Scores! Justin Schultz hammers one home and the Penguins have tied this game with 90 seconds to go. What a moment.
Oh, what a bomb. What a bomb by Schultze. Oh, this baby had flames coming out the backside. The patience of the Penguins. You have to love it, Josh. The fans were absolutely going ballistic here, but the Penguins just calmed things down. They got it in. They got the goaltender change, the extra attacker on the ice, and they quietly moved it around the top of the umbrella like it was a power play. Eventually, the beautiful one-timer pass by Chris Letang to Justin Schultz. And he absolutely wires this puck blocker side on Robin Leonard, and we are tied at three.
Snaps it near side for Rust. It was behind him. Look out here. 10 seconds to play. Clutterbuck the other way. Back in front as a man. Cutting the net off the post. Bailey with the redirect. He hit iron. 3 seconds to play in the period. And the puck comes all the way back down to the Islanders' zone. That's going to do it for regulation.
Josh, what are we doing? Brian Rust has a clear lane to make a pass. It's 5 feet behind Jake Gensel. The counterattack by the Islanders. And in the dying seconds, if it's not for the iron, this game is over. Holy moly, boys.
Justin Schultz passing up the left wing for McCann. Back for Schultz, intercepted by Boychuk. The outlet finds Kunockel through the neutral zone, over the Penguin line, down the left wing. Dances around Matta, cuts to the net. Save made by Murray. The puck rolls towards the net. Murray was knocked into the net. The net was knocked off its moorings. Play is stopped. Kunockel's in the blue paint on his back.
Oh, boy. Holy Matta. How do you do? And the see you later by Tom Kunockel puts it right between the legs of Olli Matta on a one-on-one situation. And then the puck rolls off of the stick of Tom Kunockel as he slams into Matt Murray.
They might take a look at this. And they are. Francois St. Laurent's going to put the headset on. This was very close with the net coming off and the puck rolling in.
Olli Matta completely playing the puck there. Yeah, but you've got goaltender interference too. You've got it waved off on the ice. As the net comes off, Murray slammed back into the goal. As the puck does eventually roll into the net. But by that point, the net and Murray have been completely dislodged at the same time.
Headsets
off. For multiple reasons, really.
So a minute 12 into overtime. Somewhat of a lengthy review. Let's go down to ice level for Francois St. Laurent's verdict.
After a review, the puck did not enter the normal position of the goal. Therefore, we have no goal on the ice.
Fires right through the neutral zone for Letang. Back the other way, loses control of the puck in the slot. Bailey chips it out the center. Here comes Barzal. Down the left wing in the Penguin zone. Near circle, cuts between the hash marks. Puts on the brakes to the backhand. Off the post, the rebound. They score. Josh Bailey puts in the rebound, and the Islanders take game one in overtime by a final score of 4-3.
Well, I talked about it all night. Little plays, details. In the playoffs, they can burn you. And Chris Letang overskates a puck about 5 feet inside the blue line. And the quick counterattack by the New York Islanders. And Mark Barzal was a partial two-on-one. The Penguins were scrambling to get back to make it a two-on-two. He gets Brian Dumoulin to go down. And the Penguins are hanging around here. They might be challenging this for possible offsides.
Well, every single Penguins coach on the bench has had their head fixated on the monitor.
Yep.
And none of the Penguins have left the ice. They're all standing right around the bench. I mean, I think the Islanders kind of realized what was going on here after a bit of celebrating, and they've made their way towards their bench. So hold the phone for a second.
Yep. Eberle. Might have been, oh man, it's close. You have to challenge this. But my quick glance was Eberle's skate was still touching part of blue. When Barzal coming down the left wing, cut to the middle of the ice, Eberle with the center lane drive, and then Barzal got Brian Dumoulin to go down early, and then he was all by himself.
It's a good goal. So that'll do it for game one. The Islanders strike first in this series. They win 4-3 in overtime, thanks to a goal from Josh Bailey.